What if you could take everything you love about apps on your iPhone or iPad and blow them up to 65 inches? That's the promise of the new Apple TV. The Apple TV box has been around for years, but the latest version is bigger, better, and more expensive, starting at $150 in the US. Both versions can connect to your TV and stream movies and television shows from apps like Netflix, Hulu, HBO, and of course, Apple's iTunes Store. So how is the new Apple TV different? It starts with an all-new remote. The new clicker has a touchpad on the top, much like the one on your laptop computer. With it, I was able to swipe around, browse titles, and blow through long lists of apps with ease. It's very responsive and feels a little bit like using a big phone from across the room. The combination of the slick remote and Apple TV's blazing fast menus, along with awesome search and rewind, makes streaming video feel more responsive and polished than ever. Other devices from Roku, Amazon, and Google allow voice search, and Apple TV's Siri does too. I could easily find TV shows and movies by title,
Stanley Kubrick,
look up actors and more, just like those others. But Siri has a few other neat tricks. I could ask for good movies, or just search within Netflix, or even ask for sports scores. If you miss a piece of dialogue, you can ask, "What did he say?" and Apple TV will rewind 15 seconds and show the captions.
What did he say?
You can also launch apps or even get Siri to tell you a joke.
Siri, tell me a joke.
Although unlike on iPhones and unlike Alexa on Fire TV, Siri on Apple TV doesn't speak aloud. But the biggest difference between the new Apple TV and other devices is the potential power of the App Store, including games and other apps. All of the initial games use the remote for control, and while it can be awkward at times, it's fun to see favorites like Crossy Road and Asphalt on the big screen. If you bought games for your iPad or iPhone, you can play many of them on Apple TV for free. And Apple TV also promises a fresh, big screen look for apps that aren't related to TV or gaming. You can check out real estate via Zillow, look for places to stay at Airbnb, or even exercise with an app called Zova that works with Apple Watch to track your heart rate. With Apple's clout and motivated developers, I expect thousands of apps to hit the big screen soon. Whether you'll actually want to use them on your TV as opposed to your phone or tablet remains to be seen. I'm David Katzmaier for CNET, and this is the new Apple TV.